The current debt is about $24 trillion. That's not how debts work, so we have not calculated that.
The answer is $91,207 per American citizen. How much does each taxpayer, how much does each taxpayer owe to cover our current $30 trillion debt, not $24 trillion?
And I'm sorry, I have 22.3, so I'll correct myself downward since we're using different numbers. Again, we don't calculate the debt by a person, including my five-month-old.
Excuse me, Director. The answer is $242,500 per taxpayer in America. Now, you may have been on track with some of these answers if your numbers were correct with the $30 trillion debt that we actually are at right now. But I would have hoped that you would have the correct answers in your position to all of these questions, as the president and this regime really should keep this debt at the forefront of our thinking in proposing a budget. But this budget that was created is proposed to spend another $5.8 trillion this fiscal year and $73 trillion over the next 10 years. And sadly, it's pretty apparent that you're more concerned with continuing to spend trillions of dollars of taxpayer money on liberal wish lists rather than doing anything substantive to rein in wasteful federal government spending. Now, I've said multiple times, the federal government does not have a revenue problem. It has a spending problem. Now, Director Young, Biden likes to say, show me your budget and I'll tell you your values. So let's see what Democrats really value. The word military appears 26 times in this budget, but gender, it's used 43 times in your budget. Equity? Well, that's used 75 times. And climate is used 187 times in this budget. And Americans sure do understand what Democrat priorities are and their values. They know that the real cost of these woke policies and so-called values are impacting them. And the bill has come due for these bad Democrat policies. Proposing to spend trillions of dollars on more woke wants, not needs, is absolutely shameful, and really you should be embarrassed to be testifying today and trying to defend this $5.8 trillion budget. Now, during the State of the Union, Joe Biden said that his plan to fight inflation was for businesses to simply lower their costs, not their wages. Director Young, I'm a small business owner, and I can tell you that that's not how it works in the real world. I understand that we use Washington, D.C. math here, but that's not how it works for real small business owners. Meat is up 13%. Milk is up almost 12%. Electricity is up 9%. Now, as a restaurant owner, how am I supposed to lower my costs if everything that I use is going up? And I certainly wouldn't be able to pay employees higher wages. So with this skyrocketing inflation that's taking place, Madam Director, can you please simply describe to me, define to me what inflation is?
Sure, the cost of goods are more expensive. It costs more for the same goods than it did last year. The president is very aware of that. That is why he called on Congress to send him legislation.
Reclaiming my time. Thank you, Director. That's not exactly where I was getting at. Let me answer this for you. So Milton Friedman, who won the Nobel Prize in economics, said that inflation comes from too much money being printed in D.C. Specifically, and I quote, he said, inflation is a result of too much money and more rapid increase in the quantity of money than an output. Moreover, in the modern era, the important next step to recognize that today governments control the quantity of money so that as a result, inflation in the United States is made in Washington and nowhere else. So Director Young, in short, inflation comes from Washington, D.C., where the products we use aren't created, but the products we use are made more expensive. Director Young, shamefully, this Biden budget proposes the largest tax increase in American history. And I really think that that bears repeating. It is the largest in American history. The Biden regime either has no concept of how inflation is impacting Americans or simply has no concept for Americans who find the cost of gasoline too expensive because, after all, they can't just go buy a Tesla. How about that for Democrat priorities? Thank you, Madam Director.